Hello and welcome to another Swift and Xcode tutorial. My name's Cal and in today's tutorial we're going to be looking at how to create a tab bar for navigation in your iOS app. Tab bars are a very common component and they're used throughout a lot of iOS applications, and therefore most users already are pretty familiar with how to use them to navigate your app. The actual tab bar itself is quite easy to implement. It should only take us a couple of minutes to get one up and running with just all the default settings. In the second part of the tutorial, we're just going to do a little bit of styling, so we're going to change the color and the tint and all that sort of thing. And then in the next part of the tutorial, we will have a look at changing the default selected tab item to be, rather than just being the left one all the time, we might want it to be the middle one or the right one or so on and so forth. And then finally, we're going to have a look at some tab bar badges. So we're going to use a notification sort of style thing as an example. Creating a new Xcode project. This is an iOS app that we're building. I'm just naming it Tab Bar App Tutorial. Our interface is Storyboard and our programming language is Swift. First thing we're doing is heading into main Storyboard. I'm going to drag in a Tab Bar controller, and you can see that's already given us two view controllers as well as our one that we already had by default. And I'm just going to drag over this arrow, which is our Storyboard entry point. So that needs to be pointing at our Tab Bar controller. So the Tab Bar controller comes with two view controllers already correctly linked. And all we need to do to link our third one is just right click and drag from our tab bar controller onto our new view controller, selecting relationship segue view controllers. And now you can see that we've got that same little arrow thing and all three are linked correctly. Currently all our tab bar items just say item and have that square image. To modify this, you just want to select the tab bar item. And then there's a few different system items. I'm just selecting history. For this bottom one, I'm just doing the same thing. I'm selecting the tab bar item, and then I'm just going to choose a system item. To create a custom item, it's as simple as changing the title here, as well as selecting an image. I'm going to choose this house fill image. Next, I'm going to change the background color of each of our view controllers, just so that when we're scrolling through the tab bar, we can see that it's actually going to our new view controller. And then, yeah, that's as simple as that. If we build and run this, you've got a working tab bar controller with all the default settings. You can scroll through and it's taking you to the new view controller. Next, we're going to have a look at how we can customize the tab bar controller to have some different colors as well as some different styles and that sort of thing. So back in our main view controller, we just want to select our tab bar, which is not our tab bar controller, but the actual tab bar. And we're just going to change the item position to centered. So you can see the difference there. All of the buttons have just sort of pushed in a little bit. You can also change the style to this black or dark theme, but I'm going to change the bar tint color. I'm going to choose this dark gray color, as well as you can toggle the translucency. The next thing I'm going to modify is this image tint, which is actually essentially the bar tint. So I'm going to select this yellow color, but really it doesn't matter what color you choose. I'm just choosing this color as an example. I don't know if it's necessarily a good design. Let's have a quick look. Yep, we can see that all those colors and styles have come through on our tab bar, so that's looking good. Next, you can see that I've actually made home the middle one, and maybe to make a bit more sense, if that was the default view controller, is our home, the one in the middle. So to do that, I'm just going to create a new Swift file. I'm going to call it custom tab bar controller. I'm just going to delete everything that's inside it. I'm going to import the UI kit. Next, we're going to define a class calling it custom tab bar controller, which is of type UI tab bar controller. If you're just starting out Swift programming and you haven't had too much experience with inheritance, basically all we're doing here is saying our custom tab bar controller is a child of UI tab bar controller. So everything that's inside UI tab bar controller, our custom tab bar controller is going to have, plus whatever we add in. Cool, next we're gonna add in an inspectable variable. So I'm just saying IB inspectable variable. Initial index is of type integer and it's equal to 0. And then we're gonna override the viewDidLoad function, as well as calling super viewDidLoad, and then simply just say selected index is equal to initial index. Cool, and if we save that now and head back into our main storyboard, we're gonna select our tab bar controller and give it our class of our custom tab bar controller. Now if we head into the attributes inspector, we can see that we've now got this initial index field that we can populate, and I'm just gonna set that to 1, which is, as we know in computer programming, is actually the second item. So you can see now our home is now our default selected tab bar item. And we can also set that to 2, and you can see that the default selected tab bar item is now search. So we're gonna have a look at some tab bar badges. So I'm just gonna set the initial index back to 1. As well, I'm gonna change our tab bar item to downloads. And then inside our view controller, I'm gonna just do a little bit of tidying up, because I'm gonna copy and paste this file into our other view controllers. So then I'm gonna create a couple of view controllers. I'm calling this one downloads VC, and then I'm gonna modify this one to be home VC. And then I'm gonna create one more Swift file, and we're gonna call this one search. Now I'm just going to hit Command A, copying the initializing code for a view controller into all three of our viewcontroller.swift files. Finally, modifying the class names to match that of the Swift files. Now heading back into our main storyboard, I'm just going to select on each of our view controllers and giving it the appropriate class corresponding to our Swift file. Next, in our home, I'm just going to drag in a button. I'm going to change our button's text to New Download, and I'm going to change the font, make it a little bit bigger, as well as bold. Next, we're going to give it some constraints, so just top space to the area and center horizontally in the safe area. Not really important what the constraints are, I just want to have a button that we can click on. Next, I'm going to open the assistant editor. I'm going to right click and drag from our button below our view did load and just create an action calling it new download action. Next, in our downloads, I'm going to click on our tab bar item and I'm going to create an outlet for this, and I'm just naming it downloads tab item. Next, in our home VC, in our new download action, I'm going to declare our tab bar, just saying let tab bar equal to self tab bar controller tab bar. And then we're going to say let download item equal to tab bar items at the index of 0, so our first tab bar item, which we know is our downloads. Then we're going to say download item badge color is equal to UI color red, as well as download item badge value is equal to 1. So obviously you can make that whatever you like, but just for this example, I'm just putting in 1. And then inside our downloadsvc.swift file, we're going to override our viewDidAppear function. So I've just started typing viewDidAppear and then hit enter. We're going to say downloads tab item badge value is equal to nil. Cool, and if we build and run this project one last time, you can see we can hit on new download and it adds that little notification above our downloads, and then when we select on downloads, the notification is taken away. So there you have it, a few different customizations of a tab bar and how to use tab bar controllers. Hopefully now, after completing this tutorial, you have a better understanding of how to use tab bar controllers in Swift and Xcode. I hope you learned something, and I'll catch you in the next tutorial.